I'd like to share a book with you today. If you've been to Basha, you know we have these two dogs, and they're pretty amazing. And I wanted to write something about them, like a story about them. It turned out to not so much be a story as a way to introduce them, but it came out as Ola and Chewy, Our Family, is the name of the book. And I just have to explain a couple of things. First of all, we had to call it Ola and Chewy because the Disney Corporation owns the names Yoda and Chewbacca. Don't mess with the Disney Corporation. So Yoda became Ola, which is Spanish for hello, and Chewy became Chewy because we always call him Chewy. But it's not so much a story as a little something that's about who they are. And I want to share the book with you this morning, and then I want to tell you a little bit of a story that I think is why the book is. So here's Ola and Chewy, Our Family. Ola and Chewy, Our Family. Story by Robin King. Artwork by Laurie Hall. Ola and Chewy are family. They live in an old house with a red door on the main street of a small town. Ola is a Chihuahua, but not like just any Chihuahua. They're gray and white and black and brown, and their ears only point straight up when they're listening really closely, which is not very often. Ola came to visit one weekend when they were a puppy, and decided to stay. Whenever anyone comes to the door, they like to come and say hello. Their name, Ola, is Spanish for hello. Chewy's a Yorkshire Terrier, but not like just any Yorkshire Terrier. Yorkshire Terriers are supposed to be small. Chewy's a giant, three times the size he should be. Chewy is a wish that came true, and they arrive not long after Ola. They're named Chewy because chewing's their favorite thing to do. Ola likes to say hello with a little bark or a sniff of your hand. Chewy likes to jump and wag his tail. Both of them love children. Ola likes to sit in their lap when kids need a quiet time. Chewy likes to play when they need to be busy. Ola eats his food very slowly and thoughtfully. Chewy can't get enough and gobbles it down quick. Ola and Chewy both love treats. Ola is quiet and restful and likes a good nap. Chewy likes to run and play and loves his many, many toys. At the end of the day, they both like to lie on the couch together. Ola doesn't like loud noises, like thunder or big trucks or trains. Chewy likes to howl along with the sirens and wants to see where the noise is coming from. But when they're scared, they both snuggle together on a nice warm blanket. At bedtime, Ola sleeps curled up in the same spot on the bed. Chewy likes to stretch out and move around. They both snore. In the morning, Ola likes to sleep in under the blanket. Chewy likes to get up early. When they do get up, they wag their tails and lick each other's faces as if to say, "Good morning." Ola likes to be warm. They love hot weather when the sun is shining and the grass is warm, or a comfy blanket on a cold day. Chewy likes it when it's cooler. They try to find a shady spot with a nice breeze or lie on the wood floor where it's cool. Both love to be outdoors, in the backyard or on a walk around their neighborhood. Ola has soft, light fur that's very short, and they love to have it brushed. Chewy's fur grows really fast and long. They don't like getting a haircut.
Ola and Chewie are both beautiful. Ola and Chewie are very different. They are each their own self. Ola and Chewie love each other just as they are. Ola and Chewie are family.
The thing is, like, some of you who know Yoda and Chewie, some of you who know Yoda and Chewie will have already realized that some of that isn't entirely accurate, especially if you happen to have come to the church one day when Yoda and Chewie are here. They don't like to greet you with a little bark and the lick of your hand. They go ballistic. They go crazy. Their tails are wagging like nobody's business because they're happy to see you, but they're just barking up a storm. And to be honest with you, during the winter, neither of them likes to get up in the morning. The thing is, they're very different, and yet they're family. And there's a reason for that, I think. It's because they have a home. They have a home where they can be who they are, and no one tries to make them anything they're not. We don't try to make them guard dogs. We don't try to train them to do tricks. We don't try to train them to be like support dogs. We don't, they're not farm dogs. They're very definitely who they are. And they live somewhere that provides them a place where they get to be who they are. And they very definitely have their own personalities. And somebody takes care of them and feeds them. Someone makes sure they stay warm, they get exercise. Somebody loves them. And in loving them, helps for them to be who they are and to learn about themselves. That doesn't just have to be a home that's a house. It can be a home that's a church. It could be a home that's a school. It could be a home that's our community. It could be a home. It could be a home at the arena. It could be a home at the gym. The point is, in order for us to learn and grow, and to be on that journey of finding out who we truly are, we need to be in a place where we're safe to do that. Because Jesus is all about us living true to ourselves, true to the good, the image of God that's in us. And if we are able to find ourselves in a place where we can do that, well, we're home. And we should. The thing is, we shouldn't be able to just find a space that's like that, because we're all children of God. We should be working towards a world that's like that, because we are all children of God. When Jesus talks about heaven being here, that's what he's talking about.